going to start quite yet. Because of the inclement weather, I am told we're going to take this opportunity to take the class photo right now while we have everybody together. So if you'll give us just a moment to do that, and then we'll get started. Good afternoon. I'm Mac Henson. I'm the president of the Board of Trustees, and on behalf of the board and the faculty and the staff, it's my privilege to welcome you to the 13th commencement of Eastside Preparatory School. I said during last year's graduation ceremony that I sincerely hoped it would be the only virtual one that we would be forced to have, and I had no idea then, and I don't think any of us did, how much of a close-run thing it was going to be here today. We have much to be grateful for as we see the waning of the pandemic, and the ability to be here together today is certainly one of those things for which to be thankful. As a parent of EPS graduates and current EPS students, I fully realize the challenge that all of you as students have faced in the past year. You're to be commended for your fortitude in the face of obstacles, and your adaptability in what's often been a chaotic environment. There are lessons that you've learned that'll hold you in really good stead in the future. And that future begins today. I'd like to leave you with a couple of thoughts. Firstly, Sally Grimes is the CEO of Clif Bars, wrappers of which I find around my house all the time. I read something several months ago that she said, and it struck me as really profound. Humility is not the opposite of confidence. It's the freedom for learning. I would encourage you as you go forward to find ways to practice humility. It doesn't mean that you don't know what you know, and it doesn't mean that you're not confident in what you know. It simply means that a humble mind fully knows that there are things to be learned. Be open to those who can teach you. The people from whom you will learn the most in going forward are almost certainly not going to be labeled teacher or professor. The freedom to continue to learn is a great gift, and humility creates a capacity within all of us to do so. You'd be wise to seek it. And secondly, a predicate for life, a life of learning is curiosity. I read last week something someone wrote that said, curiosity is better than being smart. And I'd have to fully agree with that. Ask why. Ask why not. Don't be afraid to say, I don't know. A very, very wise friend of mine taught me very early in my career some really powerful words. And those words were, help me understand. Practice humility, find the freedom for learning, and always, always be curious. The poet E. Cummings said, once we believe in ourselves, we can risk curiosity, wonder, spontaneous delight, or any experience that reveals the human spirit. We wish for you a life of curiosity, of wonder, and of delight in the shared experience of being human. Congratulations and best wishes to you all.
So glad that we can all be here together today. And class of 2021, we are so proud of you. The class of 2021, that unfortunate group of seniors who lost their senior year to the novel coronavirus. The class of 2021, that amazing group of students who took from that experience strength, wisdom, and empathy. When I think of you, when I think about what you've accomplished this year, when I look at you, I don't see regret. I don't see self-pity. I see leadership tempered in the furnace of misfortune. I see the feeling and self-forgetting that is born of collective struggle. You all did that. You all made that of this experience. As the world seemed to melt around you, you chose to lean in. You chose a harder path when it would have been easier and justified to simply give up or give in and ride out your time here. And you didn't do that. I was thinking how to conclude this year for you. What could I possibly say that would bring some conclusion to this wild ride of a senior year that you all have had? And often people try to give some advice, or this is the last chance that I can be a teacher. And I thought it would be better actually to think about and to reflect upon what you all have taught me, or what I've learned from working with you this year. And as I thought about that, as I was preparing these remarks, I was reminded of a friend of mine who I have had a long relationship with. He lives back in New York. He's the kind of a friend who you go to with your problems, you vent from time to time, and when I thought about what you all have taught me, it reminded me of something he told me many years ago. Usually these conversations were me complaining, and I can remember one of them when my kids were young, adulting was hard, I was a young teacher, I think I was complaining about school and how hard it was to be a teacher, and I had one of these conversations with him, and at the end of it, I said something like, this is too hard, this isn't fair, why do I have to do all this? And he paused, and he turned to me at about 60 miles an hour down the highway. He stopped looking at the road for a bit too long, and he said, man, you don't have to do that, you get to do that. And I had nothing else to say. It was one of those moments. And we were in the car, traveling at a high rate of speed, as I just mentioned. So I just kind of sat there and felt kind of childish and kind of selfish for the rest of the ride. And just like that, you all have made that choice. You all have made a choice to take this year, to take what, by all measures, was an unprecedented set of circumstances. And you have embraced technology to participate in classes in new and meaningful ways. You have patiently supported your teachers and your friends as you've learned they've learned to teach and learn in new ways with awkward and sometimes delayed moments. You've stayed connected with one another despite distance and isolation. You've kept school traditions alive. You've planned social events. I mean, you all staged a virtual Winter Wars and the best darn prom anybody can remember. Am I right? A round of applause for the class of 2021. And in addition to that, you continued to lead our school community to become more equitable, to be more inclusive, to celebrate our rich cultural diversity through assembly presentations and club-sponsored activities, and what I hope is the first of many, many more EPS culture nights. And now the storm is subsiding. Now we're at a moment at the end of your senior year, the end of high school, sort of like the end of the pandemic, although we're not quite out of the woods, it feels to many of us like the worst is behind us. School, the economy, society is reopening. Vaccines are widely available in the United States. You deserve a few months of blissful summer recreation before leaving for college in the fall. You have earned it, so please enjoy this time. There is much hope in the future, and there is reason for great optimism, but there is trouble too. As you know, many parts of the world are still struggling through deadly virus surges and vaccine shortages. I recently read in The Atlantic an article that suggested in order to stave off future resurgence of COVID-19, the United States needs to lead the way in helping other parts of the world become more vaccinated, more widespread vaccination. We live in a truly interconnected world, and our own society remains strained by the unresolved legacy of slavery, racism, racial violence, not to mention the breakdown of political institutions and widening disparity of wealth and income. The global environment, our very atmosphere, requires urgent action to ward off the worst effects of climate change. These challenges are great, and we need your contributions to make the world better. As you embark on the next leg of life's journeys, the past 15 months will surely leave its marks upon you. At every fork in the road, you get to choose whether you go left or right, and every once in a while, you get to gaze back and make meaning from the experiences that you've had. You're at one of those points now. As you step into this future that contains so many still unknowns, you will choose whether to hunker down and ride it out, or lean in, engage, and solve these great problems. My hope for you, our hope for you, the thing we've been training you for intentionally and circumstantially, is to embrace the people and circumstances you encounter and make a better world. That's not something you have to do, that's something you get to do. And we're very excited to see you do it. Thank you. Congratulations, class of 2021. It's my great pleasure now to introduce our two student speakers, first Ethan Bell and then Sydney Vernon.
Congratulations, everybody. It's actually happening. We're actually graduating. But before I can do that, I would actually like to thank my parents. They've done so much for me over the years, and I wouldn't be here without them. I'd also like to thank Dr. Stegman for giving me this opportunity to speak to you guys. But really, I'm here to talk about my teachers and classmates. I feel like the class of 2021 has this interesting sense of unity. I don't know. It's hard to describe, but I feel like I can see it so much in this very room. Every class would probably say this, maybe, but I really think that there is something here. Maybe it's all the stuff we've been through together, all the service days where we planted trees or made paths or something, or that one clause that we learned lit in that one time. Oh, maybe it's the time when we got like Microsoft Linked or whatever it was called, man. I don't know how that happened. Or maybe it's all the EBCs we went on, or all the EBCs we almost went on. Subsequently, all the Instagram posts where we like try to tag like 70 people or something. Or the homecoming games, the dances, the broken down buses, the hallway conversations, the rants, or the actual sincere talks. Maybe it's that I feel like we've seen each other grow and literally become ourselves right in front of each other's eyes. I was recently reminded of, honestly, a beautiful moment that we all had during our junior overnight. Prova Violet actually brought this up in her video. I just thought it was too exemplary of our grade to not include it here. On the night of that trip, there was this beautiful sunset. I specifically remember all of us just kind of gravitating toward the shore just to take a look at this stunning display of nature. Nothing scheduled, just all of us walking down there to watch the sun dip below the horizon. This moment was almost as beautiful as the sunset itself. I remember we just kind of like hung out there for a bit, just, I don't know, taking pictures. There's a lot of pictures in the yearbook about this. Screwing up other people's panoramas, skipping rocks, standing on logs, being stupid, I don't know. But I remember this was one of the few moments that I actually felt most connected to you all. Just appreciating nature, having fun, the excitement of a new school year filling our spirits. It was great. And then I think like 30 minutes later, I ate like 3 brownies or something, Connor and I did, and I got like 1 hour of sleep that night. But you take the goods with the bads. You know, coming back from a hiatus, I was expecting it to be a little bit strange, and while it was a little bit weird at first, it seemed like we all returned back to normal just like that. I felt like I was able to return to that conversation with that one friend that I hadn't interacted with like for a year, like the COVID pandemic was just one long crappy week. I mean, the conversation just flipped. Let me give you an example. Hey man, it's been a while. What vaccine did you get? Oh, I got Pfizer. Oh, me too. It started out like that. I mean, I felt like that conversations and friendships actually really did spark up really nicely. I don't think we would have been able to do that if we didn't have such a strong sense of togetherness as a grade. But I also think we owe it to the teachers as well. You teachers have not only been amazing for the past 4 years, but especially during the pandemic. I know that many of us, including myself, have been inspired by you all. You have not only given us the tools to make the world a better place, but you've been a friend to us on many occasions, and I'm really going to miss that. I think we can all agree what sucks the most right now is that in the past couple weeks, actually, things start to feel normal again, and we're graduating. But I believe that there's always something that we can take away from this experience, this feeling that we're cheated out of our senior year. Firstly, that we should not define our weird high school experience by its weird ending. A TV show that ends bad is not necessarily a bad TV show. Think of How I Met Your Mother, Community, Game of Thrones, stuff like that. I also believe that there is one quote that can be applied here. It's actually my senior quote because I love it so much. It's coined by Mr. Ping himself from Kung Fu Panda. If you don't know, Kung Fu Panda is a very good movie about a panda who learns Kung Fu, and he uses it to save all of China and becomes something called the Dragon Warrior. His dad is also a goose, and his dad, Goose, owns like this restaurant and serves village. It's a noodle restaurant, and he has this very tasty dish called secret ingredient noodle soup. So the quote is, there is no secret ingredient. I actually think it applies here. While in the movie, it was like some sort of character development thing for the Kung Fu Panda Master, I actually interpreted it as like, there is no secret ingredient to life, to happiness, to fulfillment. There's no step-by-step procedure to feeling complete. You just kind of have to go with it. A lot of commencement speeches talk about the next 4 years and how important they're going to be and how we're going to make a difference and all that. And while that's true, I think it's very easy, especially as private school kids, to kind of get stuck in the future, to kind of always think about what's going to happen instead of just living in the moment. So what I think I'm trying to say is take a step back. Stop thinking so much about the future. Just like with the pandemic, you never really know what's going to happen, but if we all choose to live in the moment a little bit each day, just like we do with that sunset, we may find more fulfillment than we ever could have found otherwise. The only way to find true fulfillment is to stop searching so damn hard for it. That's my advice. Anyway, congratulations again. It was a pleasure being with you guys for the past 4 to 7 years. And I know you're all gonna do amazing out there. I'll truly miss all of you. Thanks for everything.
Quite the journey. Since my sister was new to Eastside Prep as a ninth grader this year, just like I was a few years ago, I've been thinking a little bit about my first memories at EPS. And specifically, I've been thinking about that commute between the annex and main campus that defined our freshman year. And I've been thinking that since my sister is currently injured, she would have had dibs to ride in Mr. Stanitsky's coveted annex shuttle golf cart situation whenever she wanted. And when I was done wondering why I couldn't have sprained my ankle right in time for high school, I realized that I actually met some of my closest friends on that walk. Very quickly, what seemed to be an inconvenience as Tally was being constructed turned out to be a great, if unusual, introduction to EPS. I remember so many sidewalk conversations about the growing athletics programs, medieval literature, the Fuser Project, and the beloved late coffee cart. And that's how I got to know the class of 2021. Passionate and endearingly quirky with dedication and initiative. From the EPS campus evolving around us to the series of unfortunate events that was our upperclassmen experience, our class has been shaped by change. Particularly through all of the changes brought on by the pandemic, those same values of dedication and initiative have been clearer than ever. I have been so endlessly inspired by my classmates getting politically involved, volunteering, founding nonprofits and businesses and movements, and educating themselves and others outside of the classroom. I've also been inspired by our teachers, who are our mentors in academics, extracurriculars, and life in general, and who might have had the hardest task of all during online school. Thank you especially to our junior year American history teachers and our senior year social science teachers. They taught us through 2 impeachments, 1 attempted insurrection, several waves of COVID, a global reckoning with systemic racism, in a world of increasingly polarized and biased information and media, even helping us approach one of the most influential presidential elections of our lifetime. but whether they're educating us as citizens of the world, equipping us with the STEM or language skills we'll need to make the change we want to see in that world, encouraging our artistic expression, or generously hosting seminars and clubs, we appreciate our teachers more than they know, even when they forget they're on mute. Thank you also to the administration and to our athletic staff and coaches for organizing a return to hybrid school and sports. The opportunity to come together as a class or as a team in person and far, far away from together mode has been one of the highlights of my EPS experience, and right in time for senior spring. It joins other favorite memories from the last 4 years, like TMAC free period shenanigans and weekend cross-country meets, technical difficulties that turn into inside jokes, excited side conversations in the Tally Theater while we wait to hear about that year's EBC trips, grade-wide overnights, and that heart-wrenching senior circle at prom. I'll remember all of these things when the friends I've made here become the world's best and kindest leaders, making a difference in every field imaginable. I could not be more proud of our grade or grateful to have been a part of Eastside Prep. We entered high school at a critical point in EPS history, and today we graduate at a critical point in world history. Through all of the changes in between, we grew together as a class and grew as people who are now ready to make change of our own. Thank you.
Thank you all for taking the precautions necessary to make it possible for us to hold a live commencement today. It was painful last year not to be able to celebrate together. A great deal was done to compensate then, and efforts have continued throughout the past 12 months. I'd like to ask us to thank Bob and Vicki Baldwin, the entire technology team, our miracle workers in dining services, and our amazing facilities team, whose tireless efforts kept us functioning during an uncommon and unpredictable time. Special thanks to faculty and staff who, against all odds, made learning happen. Bravo to Kim Eng, who made the team sports program possible and who spent an average of 14 hours per day in league meetings trying to decide whether we could play anything ever. Finally, I must preface these remarks by telling you that Dr. Hinson and I did not write our speeches together. Not until my speech was in the can did I read Dr. Hinson's remarks. And in a few moments, you'll understand why I'm telling you this. You might even renew your confidence in telepathy. If I've learned anything during the past year and a half, it would be that the capacity to form assumptions may be a significant barrier to effective human interaction. Assumption syndrome is a condition that afflicts us all. We're held hostage by our own beliefs. We've created a frighteningly divided country because of the assumptions we continue to make about people we don't know. We're at risk of assuming ourselves to death. There are, of course, some useful assumptions that make the world work, but the assumptions that allow us to confirm beliefs and notions that are entirely false are extremely dangerous. When I was 5 years old, I didn't go to preschool or kindergarten, and Bart Gummery would have you believe that it's because they had not yet invented preschool or kindergarten. So first grade was my introduction to the world beyond my family, that world in which they don't have to love you unconditionally. As had been my practice every day for those first 5 years, I took a nap after lunch. Nobody told me not to take a nap at school. So from the first day of school, and a couple of days later, when I was, pardon the pun, rudely awakened, I took a nap at my desk. My teacher contacted my mother to let her know what I was doing, and on day 3 of first grade, my mother told me that I needed to stop taking naps at school. I was very confused, because I just thought everyone took a nap after lunch. When I learned that they weren't sleeping, and I was so embarrassed, because my teacher said nothing, even though she knew I was clueless. Most important life lesson of all, be careful about what you assume. Imagine the world we could make if everyone withheld judgment until they actually knew someone. And how enlightening would it be if even after someone is known, they're allowed to evolve and change? What would our lives be like without stereotypes? How liberating would it be if everyone was respected just because they exist? Be careful about what you assume. Have you ever found yourself so certain about an outcome that you already knew it before you actually knew it? How did you feel when you were wrong? Have you ever expected an A and earned a B plus? Show of hands. Have you ever thought you were being unfairly treated and then realized that you were only offended because what you assumed would happen didn't? Have you ever been absolutely certain that some disappointment or other would destroy your whole life? Don't you feel stupid about that now? One of the things we do in this country is encourage and praise individuals, sometimes regardless of what has truly been accomplished. Everybody gets a blue ribbon at the end of the race. Every opinion is as valid as the next. Those signals conspire to create in some of us a perception of ourselves as deserving, as entitled to whatever it is that we may desire. Whether it's a grade or some other kind of recognition, it's easy to fall into the trap, that of believing that something should be the case just because it's what you want. Check yourself the next time you feel that you've been slighted. What really took place? What words were actually spoken? How much of what you heard or saw was what you actually heard or saw, and how much was a product of your own assumptions? And here's where you recognize Dr. Hinson and our partnership. As you develop the capacity to avoid either automatic or cynical dependence on assumptions, you will discover the true meaning of humility. Humility is a strength. It projects absolute respect, generosity, a hand extended in a gesture of kindness. Because humans have the capacity to imagine what might be the case, we sometimes lose our way. Humility can protect us from manufacturing a reality that we then believe exists. To be humble is to be authentically open, receptive, and curious. Imagine a world in which authentic, humble people engage with one another. There is a way to guard against becoming a victim of your own beliefs. Be truly present. Pay attention to the moment that you're in when you're in it. The power of now is staggering. When you're focused on where you are and on what your consciousness apprehends, you are categorically alive. If you can teach yourself that this moment is not only all there is, it's all there will ever be. It's all you'll ever need. If you can train yourself to listen, to pay attention to where you are now and to the other with whom you are engaged, you will develop the ability to be truly generous, to become a cherished friend, a sought-after mentor, a supportive colleague, and an exemplar of the qualities that compose the best of the human spirit. Thank you.
Act responsibly, lead compassionately, innovate wisely. These eight words that comprise our school mission inspire EPS students to create a better world. Each spring, we select four seniors whose work at Eastside Prep exemplifies the spirit of these mission points. All of our seniors have lived this mission throughout their time at EPS, so identifying just four students from a class of 70 to recognize with an award is not an easy task. We celebrate their accomplishments in recognition of their individual efforts, which are also a tribute to the collective drive and spirit of all Eastside Prep Eagles, past, present, and future. As I read the name of the award winner, you may make your way to Dr. Macaluso's podium and she will present you with your award. The Critical Thinking Award is presented to the member of the graduating class whose keen appreciation for ideas and willingness to promote intellectual discussion enlivens our classrooms and hallways on a daily basis. This year's winner joined EPS in seventh grade and immediately immersed herself in the community. In their nomination, one teacher wrote, "She is hardworking, dedicated to the causes about which she is passionate, and mature beyond her years. She puts in 100% effort into every project she tackles, and her bubbly, positive personality makes her a joy to work with." According to another teacher, "Without any question, she is the most willing to promote intellectual discussion and to enliven our classrooms, hallways, and online experiences." This is the student you want in your classroom, in person or online. She loves being there, loves to engage with the material, and loves to connect with her teachers and fellow students. She is unfailingly positive, laughs freely, asks questions that other students are embarrassed to ask, breaks silences, vocally supports other students for their participation, plays games with enthusiasm, contributes meaningfully to small group discussions even when her co-participants put themselves on mute, and in every way elevates the learning experience for everyone in the room. No one promotes discussion, critical thinking, and enlivens the classroom like Lexi Schuing. The Responsible Action Award is presented to the member of the graduating class who, in both quiet, unseen actions and courageous public moments, demonstrates a consistent, sincere regard for the community. It is the consistent, sincere regard that points us to this year's recipient. His love for the EPS community shines through everything he does. He is often the first student to arrive in the room, physical or virtual, and always greets the teacher with a sincere, "Hello, how are you?" Or in some cases, "Hola, ¿cómo estás?" He has served as a TA for an eighth grade literature class, been active in the Student Leadership Council, served as a peer mentor since sophomore year, and worked to represent EPS positively to the greater community through his work as an EPS ambassador. One teacher wrote, "He is kind in the truest sense of the word. He is not just surface level nice, he acts with a sense of responsibility to all in his class and expresses an understanding that we are a community." Among the many student nominations for this year's winner, one peer noted he always cares about each individual person, and another recalled he was among the first to introduce me to the EPS community. And as a grade level representative, he actively communicates with us. He definitely embodies the ideals of this award. A third student remembered their first interaction similarly. Coming to EPS in 10th grade as a new student, not knowing anyone, he was the first and one of the few people to come up and talk to me and make me feel welcome and included, they wrote. Peer mentor extraordinaire, community ambassador, champion of the underdog, king of kindness, heart of gold, congratulations, Mattia Dafieno. Mattia, I'm happy also to award you the shortest walk to the podium award. The Compassionate Leadership Award is presented to the member of the graduating class whose actions consistently reflect the importance of personal responsibility and compassion for others, setting an example for all to follow. According to her teachers, this student is the embodiment of compassionate leadership. She seeks to create a more equitable, inclusive, kind, and innovative world, not just in the classroom and EPS community, but the greater Seattle community. She does so with grace and a steadfast compass of truth, striving to see the best in others. One teacher wrote, "She has tirelessly dedicated herself to ensuring that equity and inclusion remain at the forefront of the EPS agenda. And she does all this with a calm perseverance and willingness to listen to the views of others." Another, taking the long view, commented, "The foundations of a strong female were always there, and even in middle school, students looked up to her and respected her." She paved the way for affinity groups, allies for equity, social justice through art, and assisted in creating a brave space for all students in the coffeehouse espresso shot. Her peers are also in awe of her many contributions to the school community. Several express sentiments like, "I don't even know how many clubs and organizations she's a part of. She's an awesome leader and an amazing role model for her peers." She is deeply committed to EPS and works hard every day to make it a safe and welcoming place. She always makes sure people's voices are heard and is a natural at taking charge. And finally, she has been a role model throughout high school, always showing up to events and activities and working hard to make EPS a better place. Her dedication to the school community and her passion for creating enjoyable and memorable opportunities on campus is admirable and has had a big impact on my own experience at EPS. In recognition of her tireless work and also the poise, self-confidence, and humility with which she approaches many different topics and eloquently speaks about them, thank you, Eliana Swy. The WISE Innovation Award is presented to the member of the graduating class whose creativity, curiosity, and contributions illuminate new possibilities and inspire others to similar exploration. According to this student's teachers, he is the epitome of WISE innovation. One nominator wrote, "When I first met with him, he showed me how he won a competition for an innovative 3D printed solution. He continues to amaze me in my interactions with him in tech classes and clubs. He was the driving force for making a video game that was submitted to Microsoft, and his Microsoft mentor was amazed at the creativity and approach of the game, saying he never saw anything like it before. The amazing thing is, he is still very humble about his ability, which just makes him that much more awesome. His classmates recognize his contributions similarly. I can't think of anyone who thinks as deeply and brings as many different questions to the table," one peer wrote. "He's always challenging himself and others to better understand the world." Another commented, "He always seems eager to create and invent new things, either in the classroom or outside of it. He takes innovation to a new level through his depth in research and classroom assignments." This year's WISE Innovation Award goes to Kenneth Yang. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for, the awarding of the diplomas. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Lydia Akin Akar. Benjamin Lewis Ackerley. Allison Amaro. Spencer Hall Beatty. Ethan Michael Bell. Bella Barago. Alexa Elian Krager Burris. Wade Compton Carter. Eleanor Meira Casey. Julian Crosetto. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Mattia Bruno Pedro Daffieno. Connor Justin Armstrong Daniels. Griffin Parker Day. Lexi Din Lee. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Panchali Dipankar. Megan Mackenzie Dunnigan. Trajan Bennett Espelin. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Maxwell Thomas Feldman. Darius Fields. Katie Rose Fitzgerald. Carolyn Paige Gertzel. Maxwell John Getzman. Sonika Gupta. Tristan Hager. Amelia Ruth Hawkins. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Piper Nicole Hawley. Maya Henry. Zach Hilger. Donna Warde Hobala. Clayton Johnson. Alexandra Marymore Knowlton. Cecilia Nadine Krauss McClurg. Emmy Laundrie. Madison Lee. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Sonia Lester. Subi Bon Lumala. Kaya Lee Ao Young. Paul Emsley McLean. Toby Alexander Marius. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Joshua Benjamin Miller. August Barnett Mitchell. Yeah. with recognition of lifetime attendance, Marissa Mullier. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Emily Nikolai. Abby O'Neill. Pascal Pakia Raj. Stephen Pei. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Natalie Catherine Rinker. Vivian May Rutherford. Calvin Samuelson. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Colin Scott Schaefer. Alexandra Lee Schuing. Ryan Schoenhoff. Kira Seshaya. Malika Shah. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Elizabeth Ann Sternitsky. Karen Louisa Stoddart. with recognition of lifetime attendance, Evan Alexander Suddy. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Lauren Elizabeth Suddy. With recognition of lifetime attendance, Eliana Aisa Swai. Asher Thacker. Sydney Vernon. Wesley Lawson Vorley. Jacob Sho Kitaoka Walzer. Ethan Weinberg. Catherine Whitmer. Samantha Claire Wilson. Ryan Wright. Kenneth Young. Fei Zhang.
Everyone, please rise.
At the end of these three lines, you will be alumni of Eastside Preparatory School. You ready for the tassel? Okay, you got this? Here we go. By the power invested in me by the Board of Trustees of Eastside Preparatory School and by the State of Washington, I hereby pronounce you alumni of the class of 2021. Go. Graduates, graduates. You can do the cap toss right here, but you can't come back to get it. We'll get it back to you. You can do the cap toss here, but go out after you've done that. You ready? One, two, toss. Again, thank you all for being here today. If you please remain seated while the graduates exit, as which they are about to do right this second. You're going to exit? Right. You got, yes. You're it. Yes. Good. Good. Okay, music. Suspended the 6-foot rule. Okay. Congratulations to all of you, too. You're free to go.